Yesterday, I was continuing my work on the 3-hour long sponsorship video that we are currently making. Now, the thing is, there was a way that I managed to use ChatGPT, or AI as you want to call it, to help me in the process of organizing these clips a little quicker so that way I can make my cuts faster. So let's just jump in so I can show you guys. So if you guys look on my screen here, you'll notice that this entire interview that Tom and I were working on is right here. Now, right here, you can see that I have a 60-minute preview, and then I have daily 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. These dailies are so Tom, so I was able to upload it so then Tom can also review it on frame, because we have to essentially give our comments in frame so we know what we're planning to do and what are the key elements and points of each daily video. Now, because that is completed, I now need to find key points, I need to find the story. But the thing is, it takes so much time to go through all of this, or at least to do it all again and kind of filter through it. And I decided to make my workload a little easier. So here's what I did. On the right side of my screen here, I have an application on Mac known as Mac Whisperer. And you guys can download this if you would like and, you know, try it out and pay for it. So what you do is you can drop a video that you've done and it'll give you a transcript for that. So for example, if I just open the files here, I can just put in daily number 2, open it, it's gonna get right to work. So right now, as we wait, it is now transcribing this second clip. Now this will vary, of course, I don't know if this depends on your computer speed or not, but I'm gonna let this get the transcript. And the reason I use Mac Whisperer is I found it to be a very accurate transcription app. So anything that it writes, it is so accurate that I have to do so little editing, if any editing at all, to the transcript. So that already saves me time as well. So this took a minute and a half to get the transcription. Now, what I could do is I could go to the top right here and click on copies. This is going to copy this transcription to my clipboard where I can paste it wherever I'd like. Now, depending on how big your transcription will be, you know, ChatGPT has like a limit on how many lines, I guess, you can write. I'm not sure, like, the specifics on that. I just know there's a limit because I ran into it. But I know for that, for this one, this shouldn't be too much of a transcript. So I'm going to go ahead and copy everything. And then I'm going to go ahead and go now to ChatGPT. And then what I'll do here is I'll go ahead and now say, give me a bullet list of the main ideas. And then I'll go ahead and copy that transcription. It's generating the ideas. And there you go. And then now at this point, I have the main ideas of my entire second daily that I did. That's almost 11 minutes of content that it pulled out the key points out for me. And now the beauty of this is I can now put this in, let's say, Notion, you know, which is what we use to gather everything. And as you can see on my Notion, for every daily that I uploaded, I got the key points out of it. This has saved me a lot of time on having to review the footage, mainly because this is a conversation. So this kind of like workflow works well for this. But then now, since I'm the editor and I have to edit this whole thing together, I can now just find the key things and try to find the points of what I would like for the main video. And I can just look at this Notion doc and just say, okay, in daily 2, we discuss that, let's see, it acknowledges that there are various factors and genres that may have their own rules and requirements. Perfect. I was gonna write something about that. Like, I can now just look at the key points and now I have an entire outlook for this whole interview. So this is essentially how I decided to use ChatGPT, and maybe this is a cool way that you guys can test out using AI in your workflow. But I think, you know, if you're an editor and you do a lot of podcasts and maybe you're trying to find the key points, or you want to create a story, or you're going to make something out of that podcast, I think this is a cool way to go about it. But, you know, to each their own. This is what works for me right now. So hopefully this was useful. If you have any questions, you can leave it in the comment section. Although, I'm going to be honest, I'm not huge yet into knowing how to use AI just yet. This is just how I found to use it yesterday. But nonetheless, hopefully this is useful. If you guys want to follow me on Twitter, please feel free, as I am probably the most active on that website, if anything. But until next time, see you guys later.